When it comes to issue of corporate accountability, you know, we look at it from different perspectives, you know, in terms of, because it's something that we in Environmental Rights Action, Friends of the Earth Nigeria, have done, you know, the bits we can to see that corporations and governments are brought to book. Now, because if you look at it, corporate accountability does not have one-stop shop. It has to do with, you know, first, how you deal and respect the environment, how you deal and respect with the citizens, how you deal and respect the corporations, how you deal and respect the government, how you deal and respect the institutions and laws of the country. Okay, now, because in some total, corporate accountability is all about transparency. Transparency and accountability. Okay, now, from the local level, we have local laws. But the Nigerian Constitution had, especially the 1999 Constitution, which is a product of a military regime, drawing from the 1988 Constitution and the 1990 constitutions that never operated for long, which came, some of the provisions came out to answer specifically to the protection of the corporations. For instance, putting the issue of oil and gas and anything related to it within the exclusive jurisdiction of the federal government. The states cannot legislate upon it. It's only the federal that can legislate upon it, which means that if there is any disagreement, you cannot take legal action in a state high court, which is closer to the people. You must go to a federal high court, which exists as, you know, elitist court, because in most cases, it's only one court, one federal high court that exists in a state. And before now, that federal high court used to serve like two or three or four states located in one place. And you know that those that are affected by the actions and inactions of the corporations live in remote villages, where it will be a problem, first and foremost, for them to have access to the courts, and then the cost of litigation therein becomes another challenge. Now, these are, you know, already choking the people through the instrumentalities of national law. Okay? In a scenario like that, can we say we have, you know, the right to demand for corporate accountability, where access to justice is already a problem? Now, if we equally go further, we now look at one of the critical problems that we have identified and we've talked about for years in the corporate accountability, transparency and accountability drive, and holding corporations and governments accountable, especially because we are talking about, you know, corporations now, and the major defaulters are the corporations in the fossil fuel industry, the extractive industries sector. Now, the relationship is by way of joint venture partnership between the states and the corporations creates a very big problem for us lawyers and even the community citizens, because now, unlike in the US, where corporations do business and government regulates business, here it is taken that both governments and corporations, they are into business. So you have a problem. Instead of facing the company in your drive for accountability in the sector, you are equally fighting your government. When they respect the laws of their home states and they come here, whereas they have their business, you know, their corporate principles and ethics, which they abide by in the developed world, and when they come to, you know, the developing and undeveloped world where the institutions are weak, they behave differently.